I ask you guys a question. There's going to come a time when people are going to say what? La ilaha illallah. And then one person is going to hear him and say, yeah, you know what? I heard that word before. I heard La ilaha illallah before. My forefathers used to say something like that. Didn't the Prophet say that's going to happen? Didn't the Prophet say that's going to happen? What is the thing that every Muslim should know? Why would it happen there would come a time when La ilaha illallah is unknown to the people? How did that happen? It will only happen if the Muslim du'at, this is what's making it happen. The du'at are going to say to the people, well, everyone knows La ilaha illallah, there's no need to speak about it. And so they speak about other issues. They tackle political issues. They only speak about other issues. La ilaha illallah, comes a generation who's never heard of it. Because no one spoke about it, right? Everybody was assuming that every Muslim should know it. They don't know what La ilaha illallah means. Rather, if you go to YouTube today, there's a video of a guy who asks people, Qul wallah ahad, can you read it? And they can't read it. Have you seen it? Muslims in Muslim world countries, in Arab countries, are being asked basic Islamic questions. Muhammad ibn, the Prophet's name, they can't finish off. Wallah, he's on YouTube. I'll send it to you guys. Basic Islamic questions are being asked. I'll give you an example. I ask you brothers right now, and sisters, Billahi alaykum, who can tell me what Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah, what it means? What does it mean, Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah? See how serious it is? Wa ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah. You guys say Ashhadu la ilaha illallah, and you say Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah. What is wa Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah? When you testify that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, what do you mean? What do you say? What are you saying? Who can say it to me in Arabic? Yeah? طاعته فيما أمر وتصديقه فيما أخبر واجتنابه ما نهى عنه وزجر وأن لا يعبد الله إلا بما شرع. And that Allah is not worshipped. Those are the four things. Every single one of you here, that's what it means when you say Ashhadu Muhammad. Those four points is what you're agreeing to. You're testifying. If you don't know those four, then Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah is a مجرد الألفاظ. It's just a mere letter that you're uttering. What does it mean to you? صح? هي وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. What does that mean? أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. What does it mean? لا معبود بحق إلا الله. Where did you bring the word حق from? I'm talking to you. لا معبود بحق إلا الله. That Allah is the one who's rightfully deserving to be worshipped. And where did you bring the word حق from? I'm not moving away from except لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. But where? What's the evidence? Evidence is قال الله قال الرسول. Hey, hey. Yeah. Who? That's the Deen. I want Allah. It does fall under there, but I want a more apparent, more direct verse. Well, you said لا معبود بحق حق حق. Use the word حق. Where did you bring the word حق from? Who gave it to you? Why are you using the word حق? Do you see how the matter? I'm trying to show you something, brothers. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَأَنَّ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلِ. That's the verse. But do you see the problem? Just studying لا إله إلا الله. What does it mean? What does it actually mean?